So now all we have to do is kill this guy by the car. Been sitting back by the- What the fuck was that? The freaking pirate ship! Oh my god, Sophia, you dirtbag! Oh, there's gold everywhere. Hello everybody, Grace Still Plays, and we're here with a new game called Pit People, No Time for BS. So Pit People is a game made by the Behemoth. If you don't know who the Behemoth is, they made Castle Crashers. They have an interesting, aesthetic style, as well as a sense of humor, if you can't tell from the music playing in the background very gloriously. We have our lovely advertised banner over here. So this is a turn-based comedic kill people and get loot game. Probably a little bit like longer style game than I usually play on the channel. I don't know, let me know what you guys think of the game. If you want me to keep going with it, I will. Let's go ahead and start a new game though. I love their games. I love their game style, so I definitely wanted to play it no matter what. What the hell is this? Oh, I'm a single guy. Well, I'm not single if you ask my wife, but I won't be playing this with anyone. Let's choose this then and choose it again. Oh, I guess I just really, really have to choose it very strongly before thing goes on. And here we are, greeted to the beautiful cutscenes that only Behemoth can produce. The lovingly stylized art of a giant flaming thing. I'm hoping that's just the sun. Oh, and some lasers. Wondering what the world must have been like before the bear crashed into our frail planet, transforming all we once knew into a colorful kaleidoscope of delicious chaos, and I love it. The world was more hospitable, no doubt, more orderly, more sensibly sickening because it sounded boring. And I wouldn't wait for the world to end. I can't imagine a world without the bear or the storms. Yes, the storms. Beautiful waves of emerald blood cry down from the heavens, promising death in lawless disarray, constantly upsetting the order. I get butterflies in my tummy just thinking about it. Yes, yes! Speaking of which...
This guy sounds freakishly like me.
Yes, my child. Ever since the bear fell down...
It's Horatio, the humble blueberry farmer, loving father, and the most boring creature on the face of this planet. But what's this? Looks like you've got a spicy situation on your hands. Well, it's been nice knowing you, Horatio. Not really. But now it's time for you to die. Yes, how exciting. Not for you, of course.
Okay, thank you, narrator. What the fuck? Here's that juicy family I told you about. You son of a bitch, don't you call my family juicy? Only I can say such vaguely sexual things. You guys are gonna have to let me know if you want me to read these out or not. I know whenever it comes to subtitles, sometimes people want me to read them and sometimes people don't. I think I'm gonna read them for now and you guys can let me know. Kill the farmer, eat the child. Take the house. What are you gonna do with my house? It's like a shitty barn. I'm assuming the little fetal thing that's running away that just dropped his pitchfork was my son. Stay away from my family. As a blueberry farmer, why am I carrying a sword and using a gate as a shield? Yeah, whatever. All right, scumbags. This is a turn-based adventure game. Just tell Horatio where to go. All right, well, that's impressively easy. And the clash of the titans begin. Sound the alarm! So set the path. Alright, so this is pretty easy. So we just gotta click here and then hold down space to end the turn. Horatio runs on over. Very, very gazelle-like. Shields are great for blocking arrows. The heavier the shield, the more arrows you'll block. Just like in real life. Fantastic. So, what now? Do I get to move again? Dimples. What the hell are dimples? Oh, sweet mother of Jesus Christ! Hansel's just stay inside the house. We named our son Hansel! God. All right, let us get right in front of this guy and utilize the tractor as our cover. Seems like a good idea. Yeah! Look at the bones and ass fly out. And there goes his spirit into the sky. And we have an outhouse over here too. That's kind of cool. You know what? Horatio's not going down today. Horatio's doing pretty damn good. I can see my life bar. Dig deep, Horatio. Get in there and whoop that ass. Kasplooge. Oh, it's a left and a right. Oh, that guy is surprisingly tough. Look out, the bear blood is getting worse. How long is the bear going to bleed? On our farmstead. Okay, that's a lot of blood.
I said Horatio died.
Horatio's not dying. Okay.
Butterfingers.
You. My child. Well, shit. That is, what is this guy wearing on his head? Wow, I just remembered. I gotta be someplace. Love ya. Looks like he's... Hey, I was just joking about eating your delicious child. Well, Horatio's coming for your bitch ass. You should have ran when you had the chance there, Archer scumbag. Oh, he's still alive. What? Really? You dirty whore. I'm coming for you. One more hit should do it on this piece of garbage. There you go. There goes your soul up toward the bloody bear coalescence that's going on in this guy.
And a stupid look on his face, Horatio set out to find some shelter, burdened with the realization that none of this would have happened had he listened. And to make matters worse, he's got weak arms and he's not all that handsome. I don't see what all the fuss is about, but all of this will haunt him until I decide to end his misery. What fun.
Man, this game is fantastic for, like, increasing your freaking desire to want to live. Oh, here we go. All right, yes, thank God for the air. What the hell? Jesus Christ! Oh my God, my people! All right, guess we gotta kind of wander around this way. Just follow the little brick road here. Just gotta watch out for the acidic bear juices flying down here. Hopefully that's blood. Oh, there's still, what is this? It's a creature of some kind with a little wizard's hat on. I assume that's a spellcaster.
She looked hungry. Horatio shared his blueberries. No, you shared your berries. How generous of you. Her name was Pipistrella, and though she looked more than capable, she requested Horatio's aid. You see,
Pipistrella?
Her castle was raided by grumpy warriors, and she doesn't like that very much. Go on, my little hero. Perhaps this could become a mutually beneficial relationship.
Okay. The storytelling in this is deliciously over the top. Oh, Pipistrella, grab your beer mug. You're too late, princess. Stay away from my father. Oh, everyone's losing family today. All right, Pipistrella, get in there and mix it up.
Told me you guys are stupid and weak. I don't know why he'd say that.
Okay, that's a lot of dudes. What the crap? Holy shit, is this a freaking moat of juices? Yes, kingly man. Hold him back with your scepter. Oh, Pipistrella is a brawling wizardess. She does look very capable. Here's your scepter, woman. Yay. Or mace? There's the battle cry of the women. Swords are weak against helmets. Okay, so if they have a helmet, don't use a sword, use a mace. Mallet to get bonus damage. Yeah, that makes sense. So I want to go against the archers then, I guess. Only problem is, I can't get across all this bullshit. Let's go this way. Kind of go right in the middle of these two scumbags. Can I, like, wave it back and forth and hit two for one? I guess not. All right, so how am I going to deal with these guys over here? This is going to be a real issue. Pipistrella, don't worry. I'll save you. Okay, is that a beer mug or is that supposed to be like a tiny, tiny little shield? It kind of just looks like a tiny, tiny little shield. Yeah. Let's kind of, there we go. That's a critical hit right there. I'm sharing the love. Sharing the love. I'm guessing this dude over here is just kind of like taking the beating. I don't really know what else to say other than his mustache will protect him. Okay, I've got it now. You right click to switch from guy to guy. Now it makes sense. Okay, got it. Got it. There we go. Now we've got the 2-on-3, but now it's 2-on-2. Only issue is that her crappy little mallet of power is kind of useless here because we're dealing with a bunch of people without helmets on them. Let's see here. How about if we get you to kind of move over here? And you to move over here. There we go. And it shows where they move to on the ground. Nah, okay, see, it took me a second, but now I'm starting to kind of get it. Yeah, no big deal. How far was the range that these guys have? What about your shit? Oh, that is cool, though. It looks like they can hit their own guys every once in a while, which is nice. All right, so let's put her right down here. Horatio, you could stay right where you are. There we go. That's some ass whippery. So you soft skulls killed a couple of my helmletites. Yes. We've done enough here. The castle's destroyed. Mission success. We need extraction over. Oh, all right. That's fine. Calling back to base. Wait, this isn't over yet, cowards, says the fetus girl.
Go wreak havoc elsewhere.
What the Christ is this? The freaking space shuttle. This is bullshit. How do they get a space shuttle? Yeah. Way to go.
No.
And he smiles right before his life gets extinguished by like several tons of rock. Oh, Pipistrella, how I feel for you. But now take up your mace, Pipistrella. You've got shit to helms forever. Oh my god. Yes. Oh Christ. This game. All right. Fair enough. So, do we heal or how's this even work? I guess we have to go this way. Oh, she just follows. Excellent.
Pipistrella accompanies Captain Worthless, and what a woman. Her optimistic outlook and reckless bravery captivated Horatio. So much, in fact, that he immediately forgot about his son and his home and... Yes, you did. I see. Horatio gave Pipistrella the remainder of his blueberries, and they headed for the city. The perfect place to recuperate and make plans for Horatio's inevitable failure and death. Plus,
oh,
there's a pretty good restaurant there that has great beef stew and cornbread.
There's like a couple of zombies just kind of looming around here, waving their hands at this. What is this, like the undead outhouse? Oh, whatever. Let's get over to the city because I imagine we'll have to drink plenty of mead and eat, I don't know, whatever people eat during these times, hardtack or something like that. Lost, press B. Okay.
Yes, the city, how it bustles with excitement. Keep your wallet in your front pocket.
Sounds like Jersey. We lost everything, but now we can start anew. A fight in the pit should get us some gold. Let's try to find another fighter to help us out. All right, fair enough. Oh my god, the pit is a hopping place. Like, literally, it is a hopping place. All right, let's get inside. What do we have here? You have... 0 tournament points today, PvP. Okay, let's go over here and beat up Double Axe Man. A Demiclops, might you join us to fight in the pit? Let's join souls, okay? Well, I don't know if I want to get that deep. I just want you on my team, but sure. Let's freaking do this! Oh! Yes! Yes, go to Super Saiyan level 20! Super Saiyan 20! I think they were legitimately going to Super Saiyan level 20 right there. I started to see like a little yellow... What the Christ? What is this? See, this is the part of the game where you start feeling like you're tripping on acid. Like, you didn't come into the game dropping acid or utilizing methamphetamine or any kind of hallucinogenic. But now, I'm really starting to wonder... All right, baby. Whoa, what just happened? Yeah, my feeling exactly, Horatio. Welcome, people, to the pit. Bring the helmet and the blue guy together in the center of the screen. It's ass whippery time. All right, you jerk sons of bitches. Bring it on. Okay, so we got help. What the hell hit me? Hey, soulmate, mind giving you some cover? Ah, okay. So the shield can block the strikes. This girl's gonna be beating this dude up. So I want you there. Let's see. You go here, and then Horatio, you go here. Okay, I'm totally getting this down now. It's gonna be a triple ass whip. Bam, bam, bam. Thank you, ma'am. Wow, this guy has quite a bit of hit points here. Ow! Horatio, you're facing the wrong direction. Yes, Horatio. Turn arrows to gold. I don't know how that is. Throwing axes have a chance to stun your enemies. To throw, leave a hex between you and your target. Oh. All right. Okay, I don't want you to move. Horatio. Let's see here. Don't you move either. You go over here. And then we'll try and use the crazy hex throwing. Yeah! Nice! Okay, cool. So it works pretty good, the old stun there. Apparently we're up against, what is this, like Ophelia or something like that? The princess, one of the princesses from, Enough. Bring forth the speckled horseman.
Hey, that's what I used to be called back in high school. The speckled horseman. Yes.
What's one of those princesses? Cleopatra. That's what it was. Cleopatra.
The speckled horseman. There's no specks on this guy. He's just fucking dual-wielding Uzis. Mother of Jesus.
Position your shield to protect other... All right, I think I'm going to leave. Now, can this guy's axes, like, go around like this? All right, I'm going to leave everyone kind of where they are right now. See if we can finish this guy off. Okay, cool. He's down. That worked out fairly well. We got a couple people moving up. Oh, God. Yes, yes. Block. Nice. All right, Horatio's a hell of a warrior, man. I know. I learned that from the freaking story guy. I got it. I figured it out. We'll put you here. And then Horatio, get all the way to the front. And then wieldy axe man, go over here. That should give you a line of sight to Cleopatra. All right, let's do this. Looks good. All right, couple swings there. The axes are not doing their stunning job like they're supposed to. God damn it. Oh, wow. Man, Horatio can absorb. Man, this guy can take a beating. You know he's a family man to take a beating like that. Let's see. Where do I want you? Actually, you stay there. Let me see here. Ah, okay. Wherever he is, the people, they'll turn blue if you can hit them with your axes. Got it. So let's put you there. And then I'm gonna put Horatio. Let's see here. Think about this for a second. Yeah, you're going there. That's what I want from you. Oh, this is interesting. You're fine where you are. There we go. Okay, good. Everyone's kind of moving the way they're supposed to now. And Horatio, you stay where you are too. You're fine. Yeah, excellent. Throw those axes. Yeah! Get those axes going, man. We got to stun the bespeckled warrior here, whatever the hell he is. Rock. Rock what? Rock, paper, scissors? What does this even mean? I'm hovering over this rock claw. Oh, that's, I guess, what they use when you're close enough to them? I don't know. Let's see here. Where do I want you? I'm gonna keep her there. I want Horatio to move up this way, though. And then wieldy Axeman, I'm gonna keep him kind of where he is. All right, let's do this. Throw those axes. Excellent. Fantastic. That's exactly where I wanted these people to be. And we stunned the dual freaking Uzi wielder. That is great. Oh, no. They're shooting arrows at poor Demiclops over there. You sons of bitches, you're supposed to do as I command and throw them at me. Let's get this guy way over here. I think he'll do good up here. And then she can go where he used to be. And then this guy can go, let's see here, right there where she is. And that should put everyone in line to where they'll do the best good there. There we go. Throw some at you. Yeah! We got a little bit of, that's pretty cool. The narrator that hates our guts so much every once in a while gives us the old double kill. How far can this girl move? Let's cycle. Ooh. Not everyone can move very far, so we'll put him there. Hold on. We'll put her, put him there, and we'll get him kind of over here. We'll start moving everyone up. Not everyone can move very far. Whoa! Oh, God! Oh, Jesus Christ! Betrayer. The guy's name was... Oh, Genevieve! That was pretty close. Yeah, look at it rain gold! Oh! Our rainbow is filling up with delicious gold!
On the battle, Horatio kissed Joseph on the lips and then stabbed him in the stomach. Now, you really should listen to me, Horatio.
Who the hell's Joseph? Oh, is that our Demiclops guy? Oh, we got a trusty machete as well as some gold. Ooh. A hero is stronger and has more health. Okay, so who's gonna be the hero of the group? The Berserker or Horatio? I don't know, man. I think we should really make it Horatio. The story's kind of about him. There we go. The Emperor says you fight well, he gives you a house. Take the one by the market. Wow. So if you slaughter enough people, the government gives you housing. Wait a minute. This is vaguely reminiscent of United States Society. Oh, whatever. All right, thank you for the house, then. Are we all living together? Take the one by the... There's the bear. Take the one by the market. We have a security building over here. Oh, here's our little house, I think. Or is this a tavern? Nah, whatever. Let's go inside here. So what do you do when you're inside of here? Plus one. Oh, I see. We can probably outfit our people this way. So if we click on him, it'll give us, like, other stuff to do. So, what do we got here? We have a new weapon. The trusty machete instead of the box cutter. Well, wow. That sounds... Wow! Holy shit. That is substantially better. We don't have anything else, do we? Like, there's nothing else we can do, right? All right, I think I got everyone pretty much set up the way I want to. There we go. Wow, that's some house, huh? You know, we've had trouble with some bullies by the beach. Not that you owe the emperor. To the gates! Well, great. So I guess this is how you... This is how you end up getting conscripted into the militia. They give you a house and you're pretty much the emperor's bitch until the end of time. Whatever. I like beating up bullies. To the beach! What the hell? What are we driving? Is this like a freaking like oxen pulled carriage with turrets on it? Oh, whatever. To the beach! Where is the beach at? We just gotta follow these arrows here. What is that up there? Is that a giant hot dog just sitting there? Oh, it's the bear! Wow, my mind was getting really, really fallacy. Okay, that's gotta be it, right? That's gotta be the bully. What? It sounded like we fell in love. This is how bullies get their asses beat. Wow, Eddie. Veronica said you were cool. This is Lorraine, Eddie, and Chog. The coolest. I mean, look at this sweet ride. But then your friends killed everyone at my beach party. Oh, don't be such a drag. Let's go sacrifice you to Chog at a real party. What? No way. Lorraine, run. I've seen this type of beginning to a movie before. Come on. We're blowing this joint. What is this, like 60s? Like 60s bullies? Hold on. You can't do that. Watch me, Pops. Donnie, handle these clowns. Oh my god, the freaking names. What the hell? The car just went flying on the water. It's an amphibious car. Is that like a 1969 Chevy? All right, dirtbags. I don't know if that's considered a helmet. It looks more like an angler fish. Let's team up on those bullies one at a time. Yeah, Yosef. So you are Yosef. Your fighters have a mind of their own. You tell them where to go, but they decide who to attack. Ah, okay. This is a problem, though, because this freaking shark's in the way. It doesn't look like any of them have any weapons, though, which is really good. So let's keep this guy back. Let's see here. I want you up here. And actually, that should be fine. Let's go ahead and end the turn there. Let's bring these guys to us. Yes! Come this way, you dirtbags. Have a much easier time beating living shit out of you. This guy should be able to throw some axes. Oh, you didn't throw any axes. What the hell? Oh, whatever. All right, Horatio. Get your ass up there. Horatio, let's see here. You're good. I like where you are. There we go. This should be fine. Yeah! Yeah! You're not teaming up on anyone. You're just kind of all attacking randomly. I mean, it's working out, kind of. Oh, no, they're going after my demiclops! Got Baseball Bat McGee over here doing some damage, too. You son of a bitch. Let's see. I want you to go down here. Horatio, you kind of get in the middle of all this, and you get up here, protect him. All right, go! Go, team! Go! Yes! Oh, this guy's a helmet. Okay, so those are considered helmets. All right, good to know. Good to know. Alfie the Crow? I don't know. Either way, Horatio should be doing some pretty good damage. Holy shit, our girl just got thrown backward! Hey, how come I can see how close I am to death? I don't know. We joined souls, remember Cyclops powers, dude? No time to explain. Alright, well thank you, Yosef. So now we get to see our health bar. That's interesting. Oh, whatever. Okay, so this girl... What's her name again? Pipitella? Yeah, Pipitella. We need to get her using her frickin' stuff. Oh, something happened. She cannot move very far at all right now. Why is that? Probably because she got frickin' blasted? I don't really know. Horatio, I like where you are. Stay right where you are. And you, let's see. Move back here. There we go. kind of keep everyone where they should be. Wow, the axes were blocked by the shield. Dirtbag. This is a pretty tough fight. Holy crap, Horatio's getting the living shit kicked out of him. All right. Let's see. Horatio, come on down here real quick. And then, let's see. Okay, Horatio, you go down there. You, sir, go down there. Pipitella, go up there. Help out Horatio. Kind of move everyone around here. There we go. Now we're getting some beats in. Me, Donnie, say, you cats cruising for a bruising. All right, Donnie. Guess it's a fantastic name you have. Oh, the beats are coming big time. At least the archers can't really do anything, which is kind of nice. Where do I want you to be? Let's move you over here. Horatio, you stay right where you are. And then, buddy, you stay where you are, too. I should do pretty good. Oh, level! Level up! Nice crit there. That was a man down as well. Oh, the guy leveled and he got his health back. That's pretty cool. Our double axe wielder is in really, really good condition. I may even bring him to the fray. Let's see here. Pipitella, you stay where you are. Pipitella, come around back here and beat this guy in the back. And you just go axe to sword and shield with this guy. In fact, you know what? Get right in the middle of this. There we go. Yeah. 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 Beat him in the back. Freaking brain this guy. Brain this scumbag. Don't you attack Pipitella. Oh my god, Pipitella is getting the living balls beaten out of her. Oh, she attacked him back in return. That was interesting. No, whatever. Let's see here. Pipitella, where can I put you? Yeah, let's bring you way over here. Horatio, stay where you are. And then you try and stun someone. Okay, let's do that. Just kind of do some swappage right here. Excellent. Pipitella just freaking leveled up. That's awesome. I think everyone's like level 2 now. I'm starting to get the hang of this game though. It's a little bit, the controls are a little weird just because I don't usually like mess with controls like these with the kind of the right and left mouse button. I know you can use a control pad as well. I'm gonna put, where do I wanna put this guy? I'll put you there. And then you kind of go up here. I want you in the back. Throw some axes at some people. Yeah, nice crit. And right in the back. Oh man, blocked it with that damn shield. So who are you gonna go after, guys? Who are you gonna go after? Going after my Demiclops, huh? Holy shit, my Demiclops just got knocked across the field. That's fine though, because he has the ability to get those axes out. Axes out for Harambe. Horatio, you stay right where you are. Let's do this. Yeah, 120 XP, 20 XP. Nice. So now all we have to do is kill this guy by the car. Been sitting back by the, what the fuck was that? The freaking pirate ship! Oh my god, Sophia, you dirtbag! Oh, there's gold everywhere. I, Requitar, Sophia, do claim this land for Spain. Natives, bienvenidos, will you be my guides? Yes! Oh, Jesus, did we just get another person on the team? Oh, Sophia, you joined the team. MVP for Donnie. All right, very well. As the gold falls into our coffers, that is another battle down. And I think we've done fairly well. We've completed the quest on Bully Beach. We now have a damn full team of Horatio, Pipistrella, Yosef, and Sophia. Oh my god. What a fucking group. Alright guys, I hope you enjoyed Pit People. If you want to see more, feel free to let me know in the comment section below and we will follow our team onward to glory and riches. Until the next time, stay foxy and much love.